The tale of Achilles, a figure integral to Greek mythology, offers more than just a story of heroism and divine interplay. It provides a lens through which we can view the ancient Greeks' interpretation of human strengths and vulnerabilities. Let's start by looking at Achilles' divine origins and early childhood. The union of Peleus, a mortal king, and Thetis, a sea nymph, was marked by divine presence and prophetic statements that shaped their son Achilles' destiny. Celebrated with a grand wedding attended by the gods, their marriage was orchestrated by Zeus himself, who had learned of a prophecy stating that Thetis would bear a son greater than his father, a potential threat to Zeus's reign if Thetis were to marry a god. Hence, she was married off to a mortal, Peleus. At his birth, Achilles was subject to another prophecy, claiming he would die young but with immortal fame. Adhering to the maternal instinct to protect her son and alter his fate, Thetis attempted to make Achilles invulnerable by dipping him into the underworld's river Styx. While this act granted him invulnerability to physical wounds on the parts of his body submerged, it famously left his heel vulnerable, a detail coined as Achilles' heel, symbolizing a lone vulnerability in an otherwise strong defense. The divine intervention in Achilles' birth exemplifies a recurrent motif in Greek mythology, where divine entities directly influence the fates of heroes, interweaving fate and heroism. It reflected a world where deities interacted with humans, affecting their lives profoundly. Such tales offered cultural explanations for human characteristics like strength, suffering, and demise, attributing them to the influence of a higher power. Achilles's early childhood involved rigorous training under Chiron the Centaur, who instilled in him the skills befitting a hero of his prophesied caliber. Chiron prepared Achilles for battle and a life woven with the intricacies of pride, loyalty, and fate, facets integral to his roles in later military exploits and the legendary Trojan War. Now, let's take a deeper look at Achilles' training and mentorship under Chiron. In the secluded expanses of Mount Pelion, under the guidance of the wise centaur Chiron, Achilles' transformative education began. Beyond combat training, Chiron's mentorship encompassed a holistic approach to nurture both mind and body. Chiron imparted skills of archery, spear handling, and introduced Achilles to the art of lyre playing, an integral aspect of Greek cultural life. These dual aspects of Achilles' education, martial and musical, were highly esteemed in ancient Greek culture. The ability to wield a weapon with prowess was as celebrated as the capacity to play a lyre with finesse. One was the hallmark of a warrior, the other an emblem of a cultured hero. This balanced education was designed to develop Achilles' leadership qualities and statesmanship, virtues that would elevate him from a mere soldier to a leader worth following. His bardic skills would have enabled him to participate in and influence the assemblies of Greek military and political life. Chiron's influence paved the way for Achilles to establish himself as a protagonist in war and as a participant of Greek societal virtues. The ancient Greeks revered this blend of brawn and intellect, viewing it as the epitome of balanced heroism, where physical bravery and intellectual depth craft a leader capable of handling both war and peace. Such education under Chiron instilled in Achilles the power of a warrior and the sophistication and empathy characteristic of intellectual upbringing. The legendary accolades he accrued during the Trojan War weren't merely by virtue of his divine origins or physical invulnerability, but also owed to his keen intelligence and ability to resonate with ancestral war cries and solemn intonations alike. The harrowing stages of the Trojan War tested the resilience and valor of its combatants and magnified their human flaws. Achilles, once harmoniously singing to the strings of a lyre, found himself drawn into the vectors of war that would define his legacy. Initially committed to the Achaean cause, his role changed dramatically following a pivotal confrontation with Agamemnon. Achilles' rift with Agamemnon over the ownership of Briseis wasn't trivial. It underscored deeper themes of honor and respect, quintessential to the Greek heroic code. When Agamemnon reclaimed Briseis, Achilles felt his honor as a warrior and leader disparaged. His response was immediate. He withdrew himself and his myrmidons from the Achaean battle lines, causing substantial detriment to the Greeks' positions against Troy. What ensued was the unraveling of Greek dominance on the battleground, However, it was not Achilles' own suffering, but the news of Patroclus' death that steered his re-entry into the war. Seized by grief and wrath, Achilles' return transcended his quest for vindication. It was an odyssey towards reclaiming lost honor through unyielding warfare. Achilles donned armor that symbolically rebirthed him as a harbinger of doom for Troy. His ensuing battles resembled wrathful retribution, peaking in the encounter with Hector, Troy's defender, and Patroclus' slayer. Their battle echoed through time, not just as a clash of armor and spear, but as a deeply personal vendetta forged in sorrow. With Hector's fall, Achilles momentarily satisfied his vengeance, but inflicted agony upon Troy. Manifested here were the inherent contrarieties of heroes molded by war, their courses paradoxically helmed by the mastery and enslavement to their passions and duties. Whilst Achilles' enhanced martial campaign played pivotal roles, rescuing his fellow Achaeans from probable defeat, its aftermath rippled in profound grieving for the lost heroes and for Achilles' own clipped destiny, shadowed by vengeance and valor. Sadly, this story does not have a happy ending for our hero Achilles. Brought low not by an equal in strength, but by the arrow of Paris, Achilles' demise came as foretold, a prophecy finding its mark in his only vulnerability, his heel. Despite the protective waters of the Styx once engulfing him, his heel remained untouched and thus mortal, an oversight sealing his fate. Paris, guided by the god Apollo, struck this heel during a brief respite on the battlefield of Troy, toppling the mightiest of warriors. Reflecting broader themes of inevitability and vulnerability within Greek mythology, Achilles' singular weakness augments the poignant narrative weaving mighty gods and flawed heroes together, a chronicle of the reality that no greatness is wholly invincible. This resonant tale of a heroic but imperfect figure, encapsulated by a single fatal disadvantage, his Achilles' heel, has perpetuated as a metaphor recognizing one's principal weaknesses amidst overarching strengths. Achilles' legacy in Greek mythology attests to more than martial sturdiness or tragic mortality. It resonates as an archetype of overreaching ambition limned with poignant humanity. His tale has seeded countless artistic endeavors, literary expressions, and philosophical disquisitions, shaping Greek cultural ethos by embodying heroic values such as valor and loyalty, yet signaling advisories on hubris and mortal confines. Achilles' echo through millennia underscores a reflection upon an age of heroes and sorties into the landscape of adaptive interpretation. His death demarcates not the end, but a continuance, an eternal harbinger traced in memoria and hallowed whispers. Through this profound outro resonating across epochs, Achilles remains immortalized, a paragon displaying both gleaming triumphs and sorrows, an everlasting faculty in myth and memory. In essence, Achilles' narrative is about the perennial struggle between mortal limitation and aspirational reach. His story serves as a reminder that even those touched by gods face challenges that resonate with every one of us today. This blend of heroic feats and inherent vulnerability ensures Achilles remains a compelling figure in mythology and beyond.